You don't have time to investigate and resolve every security alert, so let Microsoft Defender for Endpoint do it for you. This video demonstrates how to set up and use automated investigation and response. Alerts are the starting points for automated investigations. Each alert includes rich context of all the involved entities, like files, scripts, and processes, as well as details about the attack's technique. Once Defender for Endpoint raises an alert, an automated investigation and remediation begins. The investigation runs multiple AI-based playbooks to better analyze and extend the scope to ensure no threat was left unhandled. For example, Defender for Endpoint looks at its rich set of historical data to see if a related threat was seen on other machines, and if so, it'll add those to the same investigation. How Microsoft Defender for Endpoint remediates any threats it finds depends on how you configure automation levels for the machine. That's next. You define automation levels in machine groups, and in this machine group, you see the automation levels available. Not protected disables automated investigations on this machine group. We don't recommend this automation level. As the name implies, Semi, require approval for any remediation, requires approvals for all remediations. Nonetheless, investigations still happen automatically. Semi, require approval for non-temp folders, enables automatic remediation for any file in a temp folder or a user's download folder. And Semi, require approval for core folders, enables automatic remediation for any file that's not in a system directory, like the Windows or Program Files folders. Last, Full, remediate threats automatically, allows Microsoft Defender for Endpoint to perform all remediation actions automatically, without approval. The question remains, what do automated investigations look like in Defender for Endpoint? Coming up. The automated investigations list shows investigations for the past week, although you can change that time frame. You can customize the list's columns, export the list to an Excel spreadsheet, change the number of items it shows per page, and of course, filter the list by status, triggering alert, detection source, and machine names to zero in on the investigations you care about. The triggering alert column shows the alert that triggered the investigation, and the status column explains where an investigation is in its lifecycle, from running to remediated. Of course, you can drill into any of the investigations to learn a lot more about them. That's coming up next. An investigation details page provides a tremendous amount of information about what started the investigation, how it progressed, and what Defender for Endpoint discovered once it finished. The top of the details page shows when the investigation started and when it ended. The chart is an interesting bit that compares how much time elapsed versus how much time was spent waiting for the machine or approvals. The left sidebar provides basic information, like its status, severity, and detection source. However, most of the meat is in the investigation graph. It's a picture of the automated investigation that summarizes the alerts, entities, machines, and threats associated with it, plus the elapsed time and status. Click an icon to open the relevant selection where you can see information about it, or you can click any section heading instead. If you want the Cliff Notes version of the investigation, then have a look at the Key Findings section. It lists the entities that Defender flagged as being suspicious, malicious, and those it remediated. Depending on the automation level setting, you might need to approve pending actions to remediate malicious entities. Review and approve those on the Pending Actions page. Each investigation you see in the list requires approval before it can continue or be completed. Select a pending action, review its details, and then select either Approve or Decline. Approve means to approve the remediation action, and decline means that you don't want to take action on that entity. And rather than doing them one at a time, it might be easier to select a number of them and approve or decline them in bulk, like this.